Hello, kids! Welcome back to our Friday school or Sunday school. We're here where we learn about Jesus, where we worship, where our faith grows, and where we will study about the people in the Bible. So this is Tita Carol or Ate Girl, call me what you like. And before we will start, I would like to ask Ate Phoebe to open us the word of prayer.
Lord, please let us worship you properly when my Friday school. I pray for my friends, they will get protected from the coronavirus. I call DB, my best friends, and Abby, and Jay, I call DB, and the rest of the ones, even the Yao. And I pray, Lord, that our worshiping will be nice to you, and we hope that the coronavirus will not spread to the world. And please, Lord, protect the coronavirus from my best BFFs, the closer ones, and please, Lord, keep us safe.
Thank you, Ate Phoebe, for the wonderful prayer. Thank you for praying for all of us, especially your teachers, okay? And next video, I would like also someone to lead us in a word of prayer or even the closing prayer. Okay, kids? Now, are you ready to praise the Lord? Say yay! Come on, let's stand up and rise and let's worship Jesus.
Jesus paid the price. Jacob had 12 sons, but he loved his son Joseph the most. He gave Joseph a special brightly colored coat. Joseph's brothers were jealous of him. They hated him. Joseph also had special dreams. In my dream, we were tying up bundles of wheat, he said, and your bundles bowed down to mine. Joseph's brothers hated him even more. Joseph had another dream. The sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowed down before me. His father and brothers grumbled. Are you saying you will rule over us? One day, Joseph's brothers were in the fields watching their sheep. They saw him coming to see them. They planned to kill him and put an end to all his dreams. It would be wrong to kill our brother, said Reuben. Let's throw him in this empty well. So they tore off Joseph's special coat and threw him into the well. Ishmaelite traders came by on their way to Egypt. Let's sell Joseph as a slave to the Ishmaelites, suggested Judah. So the brothers sold Joseph for 20 pieces of silver. The brothers dipped Joseph's coat in goat's blood and showed it to Jacob. My son is dead, he wept. Meanwhile, Joseph was taken to Egypt, but God was with Joseph. In Egypt, the Ishmaelites sold Joseph to Potiphar, one of Pharaoh's captains. God blessed Joseph and made him successful. Potiphar put Joseph in charge of his whole household. Dreams come true. Joseph served Potiphar well. Potiphar's wife wanted Joseph to sin against God. Joseph refused, so she lied about him. Potiphar believed her, and Joseph was thrown into prison. In prison, Joseph met two of Pharaoh's servants. They each had dreams, and God showed Joseph their meaning. Joseph's explanations came true. The cupbearer was released, and the baker was hanged. Two years later, Pharaoh had two troubling dreams. The cupbearer remembered what Joseph had done for him and told Pharaoh. So Pharaoh sent for Joseph and told him his dreams. God showed Joseph the meaning of Pharaoh's dreams. For 7 years, a lot of food will grow, said Joseph. So store up food because 7 years of famine will follow. Pharaoh was impressed by Joseph's wisdom, so he put Joseph in charge of storing up all the food. Apart from Pharaoh, no one in Egypt was more powerful than Joseph. Joseph's brothers went to Egypt to buy food. They bowed before Joseph, but did not recognize him. When he saw that they had changed, he told them who he was. The brothers were terrified. You meant to harm me, Joseph said. But God used that for good. Bring all of our family to Egypt. We will have plenty to eat.
And that is for our Friday school or Sunday school today. Thank you for that story about Joseph. I hope we could get a lesson about the life of Joseph, right? So kids, before we will end this video, we're going to pray. Okay, so let's fold our hands and bow down our heads. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we want to thank you and we give you glory and honor to you this today. Lord, we thank you for this video, for this virtual Friday school or Sunday school that we have right now. We thank you for blessing our kids and their family. May your protection be upon them and continue to nurture them and give them the good health. And we pray for whoever who are sick right now. I pray in the name of Jesus you will heal them. Lord Jesus, today we thank you for everything that you have done in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So bye-bye. Have a nice week for all of you. See you next time. Bye.